All right, so this is why you come all the way to Vancouver Island, British Columbia, because somebody has, turns out, two of these laying around. And this is a Hundredsted controllable pitch prop system. That's the hub. And the only thing that's missing is the blades, which come up through the three ports on it. And it's got an actuator, a center shaft that moves in and out, that moves, oh, there's a pin that turns the blade. And so you can control how much pitch there is on a prop. So you can feather it for sailing, and you can pitch it to whatever your load is for your engine in your boat.
We've taken out of a probably a tugboat for pulling log rafts around it down to the sawmill. They do a lot of that up here because this is definitely logging country. And this is Paul and Kay. Hey. And this is Paul's boat, and let me get it out of the sun and show it to you. You've seen pictures on our website, but this thing has been years in the creation, and it is a beautiful, done example of what we want in our sailboat. She's about 68 feet long, I think, 65. And got an African Queen pilot house up there on the top. And he's got all the stainless railing on it. And he's ready to do his final grinding and start sandblasting. Then he can paint. So this boat is actually not far from the water. And it's a great example for me to look at because it shows me all the things that we're going to have to do. And he started out with this boat as a double ender. In other words, it was going to have, you know, pointy ends at both ends. And then he changed his mind and changed his mind again, which is kind of nice about the way origami boat building works. And he decided to widen out the transom. And he put in that big transom there, and now he's got a Chinese junk. And he's got some portals he's going to put in there. Egg. The rudder's off today. Give me a chance to take a look at how he did his ends on it. And this is just scrap in there. There's the actual fitting for the rudder. And it's, wow. No. Pipe. Double-sided. Nice teardrop shape to it. About a half inch wide at the end. Skeg. Wow. 1 inch thick reinforcing, half inch rod, I mean flat bar, with the skeg coming back tapered down to that. Stainless steel shaft log, cutlass bearing prop, and an extension out for the bottom of the rudder. Oh, see, there's an exhaust port. These are probably for weld on for the ingots, so it'll be the zincs. Twin keel, just like ours is going to be, about half inch thick, tapered down in the rear. In the front, oh, looks like a 2 inch solid steel bar on that. Looking down between the keels, bottom of the hull. Got a round stainless steel rod going up. Beautiful stainless work on the bow. Stainless, so if you bump into something and knock some paint off, it doesn't start rusting immediately. So just a great design work. Let's go up the ladder and see what's inside. Nice ladder. This is much better than the last one. Huh?
Told you it was a new ladder.
Yeah, it is. For anchoring, for the anchors, all stainless steel. Boy, I like this. A little bit of a raised deck here in front, right where the mast comes through, forward mast. You put a 6-7 inch step in there, and notice even stainless. He uses a lot of stainless. They got paper mills up here. Most of your stainless came out of paper mills?
Yeah, pulp and paper.
Yeah. We don't do pulp and paper in Oklahoma, unfortunately. This is new. For the, to rest the
foresail on.
Yeah, the foresail on. two hatches. I don't remember two hatches. Aluminum hatches and a nice friendly wasp.
Oh, right down by your...
Yeah.
Yeah, the wasps love it. They're not too bad.
Air intake? Oh, yeah. No, it's a stove vent?
That's actually for the head.
For the head? Ah. You're laying out more stuff inside now.
Yeah, you're in here.
There's this fuel. Are these fuel fills over here on the side too?
Yeah, fuel and water.
And water. This is the part. It's just gorgeous. All stainless steel railing for a canopy shade on top. He's got a table that goes out over the deck here. So it has a, it'll allow light down into the engine room deck table.
Engines here have cabin. And I might have like some tools along the side.
Right.
No, I've got, I made tanks.
You made the tanks?
Yeah, he's got fuel tanks in this garage over there.
Oh, okay.
And this is where they sit?
They'll be under.
Underneath.
Under the
sole of the cabin.
Do you want your lid?
Yeah.
I've got enough to get started. I've got about 10,000 pounds in there.
10,000 pounds.
How much do you need?
Per keel or both?
And both.
And both.
Do you have
20 ounces?
5 tons.
Oh,
yeah.
Wow.
You poured your lid into them.
Yeah, and then I capped it.
There's a cap on there? Steel.
Yeah, steel cap on it.
Yeah, you put a lot of framing on it.
Wheel weights.
It looks like a lot of work, but it looks like you could cut that efficient
half.
And here, you can't, legs at least a buck and a half here.
Oh.
Yeah. So, I got $10,000 worth of lead in there that, you never, it's crazy.
Right.
Yeah,
lead is expensive.
So.
It can be a buck a pound in Oklahoma, too.
If it's
clean. Those keel comes back up through there.
So
2-inch solid bar on the front side of it. And this is 1/4-inch plate on his keels too.
So
angle. And then plate.
Yeah,
and stabilizing the keel to the
his biggest problem
to the hull side.
Actually, if
you're
gonna
be
passengers with
forward mast.
But you have
pin, hold the mast in, wood mast, collar, all stainless, under the deck,
it's
like 1.5 inch angle, stiffeners, and they've been bent, and a little bit extra added on, where needed that on the side, stiffen the deck.
Yes, it is.
Frame there.
Right, the frame in the back for batteries,
yeah.
Right.
You're going to do solar, and you're going to have a battery wall.
Yeah. And,
where do you put your water in?
Probably put, it'll be under here somewhere.
Yeah.
I've got some stainless tanks,
He's been storage.
All the reinforcements for the chines.
It's just the cabinets. He didn't have a system of
two longitudinals.
Yeah.
Even for his cost.
And they're 1.5 inches.
Yeah.
So we looked at that and we found that he can get covers on it.
Yeah.
And we thought, I thought I wanted stainless in the kitchen and beyond. But having to be in so they always look scratched. They always look scratched.
Oh.
That exhaust port on the inside.
I think stainless would be okay at some places. She doesn't want to
get if it scratches or you cut in.
That's where he's going to put his portals in.
Yeah, but what Doug's going to do is he's going to make frames.
He's got the rings welded in already. Originally it was planned for no portals, but they had a ferry that was decommissioned up here that they had love affair with, so there they are. Rudder.
The other thing you should look at is Corian.
Yes. Corian is
there's the
crazy stuff that seems
to
be boring.
Yeah, because it looks like stone.
Art as opposed
to. Actually, we did it though.
You know, the companionway.
Yeah, we made this one for
20 foot. Yeah, it'd be so cheap by then.
We keep saying that.
A little reinforcement down the deck.
Yeah, I just put, a bunch of these in.
Paul, what is this for?
That's my aft mast.
Oh, yeah, the aft mast.
See, you're
just be pinned in, the mizzen. You're an aft anchor, that's what that is.
Has a big one, Nick.
The helm? Yeah,
that's
hydraulic. I need to take a steel sheet around it. Nice. Okay, the hydraulics are uninstalled right now, but there's hydraulics here for the rudder. And there's the rudder down there.
At least 20 feet separating.
That's dry exhaust coming through the deck. And then it'll be routed underneath the benches.
You made a big old. Is this going to be
out the back?
I had a moment yesterday. And
oh, you know.
I realized
stainless
I was
on the edge of the.
Oh, you did. You realized you're wrong. Oh, good, you should.
Where's the angles where the anchor winch goes? Offset, so it missed the foresail. For the sheets, I imagine. Nice doubled up plate. Those feel like half inch with stainless on the outside for the main. Look down back inside again, see what he did on the inside there. Oh, yeah. Large star arrangement of frames. Some of them going all the way across the sides, and others coming out back to the deck. All the way to the front rise there of the cabin. The capstan is vertical.
Yeah.
And off there.
Right here.
And the foot switch on the deck. And oh, there's the hydraulic lines for it.
Yeah.
That's a good idea.
And so the pulley's over on the main.
Yeah, there'd be a pulley down at the bottom of that.
Yeah. Here's the whole thing. Now, if the sun's up a little higher, you can see without so much glare. And boy, I tell you what, he's been a long time building this thing, but he works full time, and he's going to be a daddy now. Paul's going to be daddy. Granddad's so much easier, though. If you got a choice, start there. You just gotta love a land where food just grows right out there in the open. Those are blackberries. Isn't that gorgeous? We're gonna have to plant some of these in our backyard. Oh, what a sweet. Look at that. Just tons of them. Okay, back to the boat. Frankie picking his fenders up off the trips to the beach. Oh, beautiful. You can see down at the bottom of the hull where he's done the welding for the reinforcements across the chines inside. Let's get a closer look at that. So here you can see what it looks like when a weld is done on the inside. And you can actually feel it. It's got a little distortion there in it. But not much. I mean, you don't see it. Maybe when paint's on it. But, I mean, this is below the waterline. So in my opinion, the fish aren't going to care. And you see it goes down, comes all the way back up. It's a solid weld. So it gives me some idea of the distortion that we're going to get. Now we have a quarter inch plate instead of 3/16, but still gives me some idea of what the distortion is going to be like for our bulkheads that we'll put in. Because this boat doesn't have any bulkheads in, no watertight bulkheads. And we're going to put steel watertight bulkheads that go all the way from one side of the boat to the other, and that'll be a difference. And there's one of his welds, and it's ground flush, so looks beautiful.